Thou art come into the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations. There shall not be found among you any one that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee. Thou shalt be perfect with the Lord thy God.
The kingdom of darkness want you to believe this is a wonderful time of the year. The traditions many people follow during this season is nothing but a distraction from what is happening behind the scenes. Israelites who do not part ways with the traditions of men, they will become a partaker in the abominations the workers of iniquity practice behind the scenes.
Be not ye therefore partakers with them.
Regardless if you are aware of what the workers of iniquity are doing behind the scenes, if there is a covenant, you are just as guilty as the workers of iniquity who deceive you into forging an evil covenant. The judgment reserved for the workers of iniquity who cause the people to rebel and follow the traditions of men will come upon you.
And he said unto them, Oh well, ye reject the commandment of God, that ye may keep your own tradition.
Israelites, it is important for you not to forsake knowledge at such a time like this. The kingdom of darkness will send all kinds of distractions and people to steal the wisdom the Most High planted in you. Satan will send his agents to Israelite channels to create their own narrative in the comment section. By doing this, they are trying to destroy the seed the Most High planted in you from the messages posted by the anointed teachers of the Most High. The workers of iniquity love to switch the narrative and make accusations in our comment sections, and many Israelites fall for it. I advise you not to interact with the workers of iniquity sent by their father, Satan. They want to cause strife on Israelite channels and in your personal life to change your mind. The goal of the kingdom of darkness is to not let the righteous seed planted in you to form a root and grow.
But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts, and write it in their hearts, and will be their God, and they shall be my people.
The moment the people of the Most High learn to serve the Most High in the Spirit and in truth, the reign of the kingdom of darkness ends. Israelites, you must take precaution. Do not allow the kingdom of darkness to rob you of the wisdom and understanding. Israelites, you are held accountable for what you do not know. Before many of us became aware of our identity, we were suffering for the sins of our fathers and our own sins. We were not aware what was required of us as the descendants of the Israelites. Due to a lack of knowledge, we perished among the heathens.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children.
Now that we are aware of what is required of us, many of us are turning to serve the Most High in the Spirit and in truth. While we are doing so, our lives are changing and we are growing closer to the Most High. If you're not careful with the traditions created by men, you will find yourself drifting from the presence of the Most High. For example, many people believe they are drawing closer to the Most High during the pagan holiday season. They believe because they participate in the holiday traditions, their righteousness has increased and the Most High is pleased with them. Israelites, it is important to allow the Most High to renew your minds. By renewing your mind, you will be able to see what's in front of you.
And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
When the traditions of this world blind your eyes, it is difficult to see what is hiding in plain sight. It is important, Israelites, not to get carried away with the traditions of men. The traditions of men are leading many on the broad road to destruction. Israelites, the traditions that come from men are heavy burdens. The workers of iniquity disguise themselves as men and women of the Most High. These individuals are super religious and legalistic. They make themselves appear as if they are upholding the statutes and commandments of the Most High, but they are not. They place heavy burdens on the sheep while they themselves do not follow their own traditions.
The scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe and do. But do not ye after their works, for they say and do not. For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on men's shoulders. For they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers. But all their works they do for to be seen of men. They make broad their phylacteries, and enlarge the borders of their garments.
It is important that you examine your so-called leaders. Their behavior will reveal more than the words that are coming out of their mouths. The traditions they follow are not written in the Bible, especially the traditions of celebrating the birth of the Messiah every December 25th. I know many scriptures speaking against their traditions. Israelites, it is time that you stop letting workers of iniquity lead you. It is time that you learn to distinguish the wolves among us. We must break evil covenants with all seducing spirits to draw near to the Most High.
Draw nigh to God, and He will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded.
The workers of iniquity among us are sent by the kingdom of darkness to keep you in sin, in addition to break your connection with the Most High. Once the workers of iniquity sever your connection with the Most High, the kingdom of darkness gain access to redirect your life to do the will of Satan. Many people believe they are serving the Most High. You cannot serve the Most High and the kingdom of darkness. Many Israelites have been deceived to believe they can serve the Most High and participate in the affairs of this world. The traditions of this world are against the Most High. You would have to choose.
Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. Ye cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils. No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon.
Israelites, do not allow the kingdom of darkness to blind your eyes with the traditions of men. The purpose of Satan's illusions is to make you believe you are living a glorious life that is pleasing to the Most High. However, behind the scenes, deceive you to sin against the Most High by participating in the lawlessness of this world. The last 3 months of the year is very satanic. This is the time sorcery is at an all-time high. While you believe this is the season to be jolly, witches, warlocks, and all workers of iniquity are plotting against you. They are performing their rituals and making their sacrifices to their idols to set the tone for the coming year. Have you noticed violence increase during this time of the year? Many people do not notice the diabolical events taking place because they are distracted by the satanic holidays. Israelites, the workers of iniquity practice sorcery all year long. However, at the end of the year is when witchcraft is at an all-time high. Sorcery is nothing new. Israelites and heathens have been practicing sorcery from the beginning.
And the spirit of Egypt shall fail in the midst thereof, and I will destroy the counsel thereof. And they shall seek to the idols, and to the charmers, and to them that have familiar spirits, and to the wizards.
The kingdom of darkness disguised sorcery in the form of family traditions. Therefore, many Israelites and heathens pass down sorcery in the form of culture traditions. Today, there is a blurred line between sorcery, traditions, and religion. Religion is witchcraft. That is why many people who practice religion are destroyed. These individuals remain stagnant in life and have no clue to what is happening around them. They are like mind control robots repeating the doctrines of devils coming out of their pastor's mouth. Pastors and religious leaders are high-level workers of iniquity. They disguise themselves as men and women of the Most High to deceive many.
Therefore it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works.
Many religious leaders practice sorcery in front of their congregation. They use familiar spirits to prophesy false illusions to the sheep. They do not have the Holy Spirit. They have familiar spirits pretending to be the Holy Spirit. The Most High did not send them. Yah will cut them off and judge them severely for their wickedness.
They have seen vanity and lying divination, saying, "The Lord saith," and the Lord hath not sent them. And they have made others to hope that they would confirm the word. Have ye not seen a vain vision? And have ye not spoken a lying divination, whereas ye say, "The Lord saith it," albeit I have not spoken? Therefore thus saith the Lord God, because ye have spoken vanity and seen lies, therefore behold, I am against you, saith the Lord God. And mine hand shall be upon the prophets that see vanity, and that divine lies, they shall not be in the assembly of my people, neither shall they be written in the writing of the house of Israel, neither shall they enter into the land of Israel. And ye shall know that I am the Lord God.
The workers of iniquity, hiding behind religion, built their altars to idols and not to the Most High. Remember, the people do not serve the Elohim of Israel in religion. Therefore, all their sacrifices, worship, and servitude are made to devils and not to the Most High.
But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to God. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils.
The church is powerless against attacks from the kingdom of darkness because idols and seducing spirits hide behind the altars. Many people are misled to serve the same idols the workers of iniquity serve in religion. Religion is nothing but a disguise for workers of iniquity to practice sorcery freely and openly. The scripture said not to consult the workers of iniquity who use familiar spirits because they would defile you.
Regard not them that have familiar spirits, neither seek after wizards, to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God.
Despite the scriptures informing the people of the Most High not to seek those with a familiar spirit, many Israelites are lost in sorcery today. The beast system made sorcery look appealing. There are many witches and warlocks on television giving readings to the people. These individuals are whom the scriptures speak of when it say to not seek those with a familiar spirit. The psychics and mediums use familiar spirits to prophesy. The people who hold the title high priest, pastor, and prophets in religion also use familiar spirits. The scriptures warn you not to seek those with a familiar spirit. They are not helping you, but they are defiling you. If you must seek a person in secret, hiding in a bush somewhere, you should not be speaking to them. The scripture said, what is done in darkness would become known.
For nothing is secret that shall not be made manifest, neither anything hid that shall not be known and come abroad.
If you must consult a so-called person who represent the Most High in secret, like King Saul had to disguise himself to seek the woman with a familiar spirit, this conclude you should not be seeking the face of such people. They are not of the Most High. They represent the kingdom of darkness. When you seek them, you become defiled by them.
And Saul disguised himself and put on other raiment, and he went, and two men with him. And they came to the woman by night. And he said, I pray thee, divine unto me by the familiar spirit, and bring me him up, whom I shall name unto thee.
When you seek the face of those with a familiar spirit, you are placing generational curses in your bloodline. The reason the familiar spirits know so much about a person, they are familiar with that person and their bloodline. When a family member seek a person with a familiar spirit, the workers of iniquity will send spirits after the person, and the familiar spirit stay in their bloodline. Once you seek the face of the workers of iniquity, the law of the Most High said you are defiled by them. Therefore, once a covenant is made, you are at the mercy of the idol the worker of iniquity worked for.
Regard not them that have familiar spirits, neither seek after wizards, to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God.
Because familiar spirits have been around the person and their family for a long period of time, they know what to say to the workers of iniquity to gain the victim's trust. When the worker of iniquity begins to inform the victim of his or her life, the familiar spirits are revealing the information to the workers of iniquity. Israelites, it is important not to allow yourself to be manipulated by the kingdom of darkness to seek the face of workers of iniquity who has a familiar spirit. The Most High said he would cut you off from his people.
And the soul that turneth after such as have familiar spirits and after wizards to go a whoring after them, I will even set my face against that soul, and will cut him off from among his people.
There should be nothing the kingdom of darkness could offer you to make you choose to be cut off from your people. The blessings coming from the kingdom of darkness are laced with traps and not worth the trouble. When you break the laws of the Most High, the kingdom of darkness gained the right to persecute you. In the spirit realm, when the kingdom of darkness attack your dream life, they lure your spirit to break the laws of the Most High. Once you accept the deception, a covenant is forged. Israelites, it is important to wait on the Most High to grant you the desires of your heart. There is nothing too hard for the Most High. Going to the workers of iniquity for a quick blessing has severe consequences. You put your entire bloodline at risk. Israelites, ask the Most High for the spirit of patience to help you wait on the Most High. The penalty for witches and warlocks are severe. The words of the Most High said a man or a woman with a familiar spirit should be stoned and their blood would be upon their own hands. The scriptures also said that a witch or a warlock should not live.
A man also, or woman that hath a familiar spirit, or that is a wizard, shall surely be put to death. They shall stone them with stones, their blood shall be upon them. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live.
Israelites, when you are dealing with sorcery, you should have no mercy on an unrepented worker of iniquity. You are to become righteous angry and send the fire of the Most High against the kingdom of darkness and the human agents. You must remind the Most High of his words to bring the judgment of the Most High against the workers of iniquity. Do not play when it comes to sorcery. You must humble yourself and send the Most High to fight for you. It is that serious. Many people have lost their life due to sorcery. When you hear people dying and the cause of death is unknown, it is sorcery. A person dropped dead when they were healthy, sorcery. When a person suddenly loses their mind, that is sorcery. When you do nothing, you pay the ultimate price. That is why you must seek deliverance and seek the face of the Most High for protection. Praying is not enough when it comes to sorcery. The scripture said, this kind comes out only through prayer and fasting.
Howbeit, this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting.
The workers of iniquity are knowledgeable of the spirit realm and sorcery. You must know what you're doing. In the times we're living in, the workers of iniquity has sent the spirit of infirmity in the form of coronavirus against the people, the spirit of fear to disable the people. The workers of iniquity interfere with the lives of many people by changing their destiny, causing many to stumble. The workers of iniquity use their knowledge of the spirit realm for evil. The reason many of our people are at the bottom, the heathens are doing sorcery against them, Israelites are doing sorcery against other Israelites. Many of you have shared your dreams, and most of your dreams stem from witchcraft. A lot of people are under heavy witchcraft attack. If you're ignorant of how the spirit realm operate, the workers of iniquity will attack you and control your life and your descendants for multiple generations. As Israelites, we are suffering for the sins of our ancestors and our own iniquities.
Our fathers have sinned and are not, and we have borne their iniquities.
The Most High exiled his people from the promised land and scattered his people into all the kingdoms of this world because of idolatry. Idolatry is witchcraft. As the descendants of the Israelites, we were born in the land of our captivity. The familiar spirit of rebellion is traveling in the Israelite bloodline. There are many Israelites who refuse to submit to the Most High. Rebellion is like witchcraft. It goes hand in hand with idolatry and sorcery.
For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry, because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord. He hath also rejected thee from being king.
Many of our people are reaping the consequences of the sin from a parent or a family member seeking the face of a worker of iniquity. Israelites, it is important to seek the Most High to be delivered from the strongholds placed in your life via sorcery. If you do nothing about your life, the kingdom of darkness is running your life behind the scene. The workers of iniquity are trading many Israelites' destiny for the lesser, and Israelites are assisting the kingdom of darkness.
Hath a nation changed their gods, which are yet no gods? But my people have changed their glory for that which doth not profit.
There are many Israelites practicing sorcery. They hide behind religion and family traditions. The heathens use sorcery to keep their foot on our necks. Israelites, if you're serious about your walk with the Most High, you must humble yourself, especially at such a time like this. The workers of iniquity are dedicated to their idols. They will fast and pray to their idols, perform rituals to serve their idols. Israelites, you must be dedicated to the Most High and build an altar to the Most High. Many of you are building altars with no sacrifice. You cannot build an altar to the Most High and not give a sacrifice. You must fast. Fasting is your sacrifice. If you wish to see the Most High move on your behalf, you must include fasting. Fasting will bring the judgment and presence of the Most High into your life. You cannot afford to not fast and pray. Do not allow the workers of iniquity to outshine you this season or any other time. It is time for every Israelite to elevate spiritually and take their spiritual journey to the next level. In order to triumph and over the enemy, you must submit to the Most High. When you submit, the kingdom of darkness have no choice but to flee from you.
Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
Israelites, make the kingdom of darkness flee from you seven ways. Do not give any foul spirits permission to get familiar with you.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple.